Hey guys, what is up? How are you all doing? I hope you are all good. We are getting ever closer and closer to the release of The Prom on Netflix. I think this is probably going to be one of my last prom-related videos. I think I've done enough. but you know what? Here we go again. They released the soundtrack for the movie. I have not yet listened to it, surprisingly. I don't know how, I just have had one of those weekends where I just didn't get around to listen to it. I didn't have the opportunity. So I'm going to listen to the soundtrack now as it was released. I don't even know that many sounds right there. But I'm excited to listen to it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get off my phone. I have reacted already to the songs from the movie. I've reacted to Tonight Belongs to You, as well as Wear Your Crown. I have not heard any of the songs. I saw a snippet of Zaz that was released, the actual, you know, performance in the movie. So that was very brief. I didn't really pay attention to it. I was like, don't look at it, Sean, calm down. But a nice thing is I've actually had a couple of my friends hit me up, like in my real personal life. And they were like, oh my God, is this that movie you're talking about? Is this that stage show you're talking about in New York? I was like, yes, sis, that's the one. And they're like, oh, like I'll have to watch it. I'm like, yes, you will have to watch it. So anyways, I'm not going to waste any more time. I'm going to go straight into this. Sorry if I sound a bit hoarse. My voice is a little bit gone. Haven't had the best weekend, health-wise. But, you know, we're thriving, we're surviving, we're having a good old time. Obviously, the first song from the show is Changing Lives. I was actually kind of curious how they're going to do this in the... I mean, I'm curious how... Stop it, Sean. Just listen to react to the song. Let's just react to the album. Let's go. Oh, strings, hello? Strings? I love this overture. It's a very short overture, because it's basically the start of Changing Lives, but all just rolls into the one. I loved it on Broadway. No! What was that girl saying? There was another girl in the Broadway show. She was a Broadway mania. Where'd she go to? Girl, she got a new job. Oh, this is so weird. Just because, again, I'm so used to Brooks. Okay, Meryl, come through. You're sounding good. Also, this is my first coffee of the day, and it's half one. Okay, choices. Choices, Meryl. Okay, this is fun. I like this. Okay. Just one thing I want to say there is there's harmonies there that weren't there before, and I really appreciate them, so good. Yeah, Changing Lives. I enjoyed it. Let's go. Next one. Changing Lives. Reprise. Bad. It's actually, James Corden really doesn't sound bad at all. Like, I'm like, I don't have any issues with him. Or any issues whatsoever. Just breathe. Note to self. Oh, it's a lot more poppy. It's a bit bouncier than what I'm used to. Joe sounds great. Joe Ellen. I wonder if she should go by Joe or is it Joe Ellen? I'm just gonna say Joellen for now. I mean this in the nicest way possible because I love Caitlin Kinnan. Joellen sounds like a younger Caitlin. Oh, I actually haven't listened to the Broadway cast album in so long through that now I'm like, oh, I actually miss that show so much. Like I haven't listened to Just Breathe in forever. It's not about me! I heard people saying that who've seen the early screenings as well as the cinema releases, because that's what was being released on December 4th. Remember that confusion I was talking about? December 4th was cinema release, I think. Anyways, people have seen the show. And they're saying this is fantastic in the movie. So I'm looking forward to it. Meryl! Have you been getting singing lessons? Oh, it's getting me excited. This number sounds great. This is one of the numbers I was worried about. That it wouldn't be good because I didn't think Meryl had the singing chops, but evidently I was wrong. Okay, I'm not worried anymore. Choices. Dance with you. Pause for 1 second. I just want to say one thing. I said this already. I do feel like that this album already sounds more poppy as opposed to Broadway. Can't put my fingers on why I think that. Maybe it's just the orchestrations. I don't know. People said there's also auto-tune. I don't know. But doesn't sound like Broadway, I guess. I don't know, maybe. Maybe it's the larger orchestra. I don't know. Jill sounds fab. I like her. Ooh. Ariana. Oh. Ariana. Can we talk a second? Sorry, just clicked my head. I haven't thought of this in so long. Ariana Grande was meant to play Emma. This, thank goodness she didn't. On the whole Ariana thing. I love Ariana Grande, but I just did not see her as Emma. So that would have been like, for me, that would have been like the biggest like, oh no. But then at the same time, yes, the audience would have been magnified by a billion, but whatever. Are they gonna do the big note? No, they couldn't. I love that big note at the end. Are they gonna do it? No, they're not. You and me. And us. What was that I just singing? Let's not rewind that. Okay, I get it. Sounds nice. But personally, I prefer the big note at the end. I used to love that. The acceptance song. I heard the song was cut. I need my legs for fall asleep. I heard this was cut to like only a minute or so in the movie, which... It's sad because I used to love the acceptance song on stage. Andrew sounds great. I like it. Sounds good, but it, again, I heard Red that this is cut down so I can accept one another. You Happened. I love, sorry, I'm gonna pause this. You Happened is one of my favorite songs from the show. I absolutely adore it. I love it. And I remember after I'd seen the show on Broadway for the first time, You Happen, I think, was one of the only songs I could listen to at the time that was released, studio recording was released, so I just became obsessed with the song, so I hope the song does the job. Yes! Just so bored. Yeah, again, this whole pop thing, it does sound again more poppy, like the, it's, like literally, it's popping. It's weird not hearing Teddy sing it, but whatever. Love it! Gorgeous! Brill, gorgeous, so delighted. Eat luck to you. Right, might I just say this is one of my least favorite songs in the show. Again, I thoroughly understand the reason behind it and the reason why it's placed in the show and the whole point behind the song, but for me it's just my least favorite song in the show, and that's the way it is. Right, Tonight Belongs to You, I'm not going to react to it because I already reacted to it before. So I'm going to skip that and go straight to Tonight Belongs to You reprise. Oh, Joe! And it's only 45 seconds? God. Oh my god, this bit broke my heart on stage. Okay, this is definitely nicer than on Broadway. The strings, the orchestrations are beautiful. That's heartbreaking. So sad. If you know what happens, it's heartbreaking. Zazz. One of my favorite songs in the show. I love Zazz. She's got a funny accent. Is she doing like New Jersey? Am I missing something? Is it meant to be New Jersey? That's what I'm getting. Orchestrations are basically the exact same. It sounds so similar to the... I need to stop comparing. Anyways, sounds great. I like it. I have no issues with this whatsoever. It is improving. Come on, Meryl. Pull through. This is like one of the best numbers written in the last couple of years. It's so good. Actually, pause. I remember when I saw this in New York for the first time again, I had no idea about what was coming. Yeah, interesting choices. Her acting choices. But vocally, she sounds good. Like, I'm so impressed in Meryl. Sorry, I'm gonna pause a minute. I'm quite impressed in Meryl. Like, I really was not expecting her to be able to sing it that well. Again, like I said, some of her acting choices are interesting, but at the same time, I do think it's gonna be one of those things we just have to see in the movie to understand. Alyssa Green. I love this number too. This song is so sad. I remember. Oh! That's different. It used to be a bit more like just quiet. Oh, this is quite different. But Ariana sounds great. Oh, Ariana. I wasn't expecting that. Well, I was totally expecting to be floored. Love Thy Neighbor. Okay, Andrew sounds very good. I like Andrew right now. He sounds good in this. What's waiting for you? I love this number. Oh! Saxophone, trumpet? I don't know. Someone's blown an instrument in there and I'm digging it. I love Thy Neighbor. I love it all. Dear God. Barry's going to prom. James Corden, pull through, please. Do you know what? I'm actually not crazy about this number. It's fine. But I'm like, oh! Oh! He's singing that up. Great. James Corden, good to go. Oh! Wait, pause. Right, before I get into the song, Rudy Hart is one of my... This song kills me. Like, the first time I saw this, again, when I saw the musical, I'm not expecting anything, because I didn't know anything about it. When I saw this song, I was literally nearly in tears. And every single time I saw it after that, I was basically nearly in tears from this number. So, you beat forewarning. I was literally just listening to a podcast as well, where they're talking about writing this number. Oh, she sounds great. This bit is gonna kill me. Oh! That failed! No, I didn't ask for this. Oh. What? No! 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 I didn't know that was coming. Oh, that was beautiful, that bit there. I wasn't expecting that at all. Pause. Okay, that... Beautiful, gorgeous. That song is like... You know, there's some songs like just literally like... You just get... Song, and that song literally just like is speaks to me. That's all I'll say. Time to Dance, the last number. Song. Do, 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 do. There's something in the back there that sounds really nice against strings, I think. What was that? Come through, sound effects. The orchestra just feels so full. Sounds glorious. That's different, is it? There's so much going on in the background that I'm like that I'm listening to that more than anything else. All these little additions. Okay. Different. I like it. I prefer the other way, but whatever. I mean, I totally understand why they're going for this more hip-hop route for the movie. Well, I get it, totally. Love this bit. Cute! I'm not listening to Wear Your Crown because I posted that before and I wasn't a fan of it. Simply Love. James Corden? Early one morning you'll wake up and find. What's this? A note's been slipped beneath your door. It says the same thing that I wrote in mine. What the? Oh, my Lord. Did. And in that moment you'll forget to. Hold the phone. Your future has no guarantee. Is this in the movie? Oh, this is beautiful. Right, I have finished listening to the cast album, the soundtrack, musicals. What's the wording of this? Let's get this correct. I have finished listening to the album for the movie for the prom. I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a very nice addition. I enjoyed some of the extra orchestrations. I had no issues really with any of the singing. Some of the choices of the, you know, delivering some of the lines in the songs are a bit funny, but again, like, I have to see it in context of the movie to really understand the choices behind it. There's nothing I particularly disliked about it. I quite liked it all. I do know in the movie I read and saw that a lot of people said that, for example, in Love Thy, not Love Thy Neighbor, oh my gosh, what's the song called again? The acceptance song, that it cuts quite early on into that, which is whatever, because I used to love that number, but I mean, I get it in the context of the movie. So I did enjoy it a lot. If I'm comparing to the Broadway cast album, I do prefer the Broadway cast album still, because that is more musical theater than this movie soundtrack is, because this is definitely more poppy, and it's not particularly, like, that's not what you'd see on the Broadway stage, but again, this is the movie. So I did enjoy it a lot. And I'm just really kind of eagerly waiting now to watch the movie. I actually could see the movie before it comes out on Netflix. It comes out on Netflix on Friday, and I was looking at my screen times in cinema, in the local cinema, and they were shown on Wednesday, and I was like, would I? Will I? But then I was like, maybe I won't. I might just hold off until Friday. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed that reaction to the soundtrack for The Prom, which is going to be on Netflix. It's Friday. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys all next time. Bye.